Could you briefly sketch what your project entails?
Briefly is difficult, but I will try. It's a project which is about an integration of a couple of new units in an existing refinery. We are going to build a new hydrocracker unit to produce more diesel. We're also going to interlink that new unit with a loops facility to create loops to base stock.
What were the most serious complexities, or what are the most serious complexities that you face?
I'm still facing it. It's interactions on the project with all the people involved. It looks like that all those people have an own view on what needs to happen. And what you can tell is on those interfaces between the various entities on the project, you see a lot of trouble in order to understand from each other what we're really trying to do.
Is it really only interfaces? Is it behavioral only, or is it also technical complexities? Is there a balance?
Actually, it's both. I wish I could put my finger on one of them. What we see is that interaction on technical problems is much more down to earth for engineers. They can actually deal with that. They will find solutions to flaws what they actually encounter every day. What's more problematic on the project is the behavioral interactions with people. It's much more difficult to actually understand that we are doing this together.
And how did this change over the project life cycle, or are they still changing?
What brought us a bit in trouble in the beginning of the execution phase, or through the construction phase of the project, was to keep everything in sync with each other. So we saw moments that we are running out of sync with what we really intended to do in accordance with the schedule, which means that you get an overwhelming amount of additional interfaces with new groups of people coming in, trying to do something out of sync with what is there. And that means that we have to deal with that. And that caused quite some additional complexity to the already difficult task what we had in front of us.
How did you deal with the complexities that you mentioned? Or are you still dealing with them?
Yeah, still dealing with them. The biggest issue is actually to make sure that we are in a purpose of building a plant. So it means that every time when somebody brought up a complexity, they come from their own perspective on why it was so difficult in from their perspective. And they're probably right, probably so. Now, if you do a step back and you start to see how the value could be contributed to the end game or the end stage where you want to be, then it brings a total new perspective to the entire team. So people see that no matter what the problem of one team or one group of people is, we are still in the game of building the entire facility. And that is a very helpful way of breaking through in situations that people get deadlocked in their thinking.
Is it also a matter of letting go then for people, that they say you have a plan but it's good to deviate from the plan? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, it's a project manager would always say that it's never good to deviate from the plan. But the real life is that we are almost always are deviating from the plan, because every day is an interaction of a web of commitments and promises from people. And if it doesn't fit totally, then we are deviating from the plan. Now, realizing that in itself is not wrong, it's just a state where we are, and now we have to move out of it together, that is the breakthrough in thinking. So if people tend to pause a moment and just look back in history and how come that we are in this bad state and who caused that, and this is the blame game, it causes that people are actually very much defending on their position and situation. And it actually kills the opportunity to move out quick and actually move forward, because that's what the project wants.
Yeah, you mentioned the complexities here more as almost the technical complexities, where initially you said it's the interfaces that are the complexities. Are people willing to approach the interfaces in a similar way as they approach the technical complexities?
Yeah, they are. It's what I experienced over time is that, similar to what you do with technical issues, you can also see it in interfaces. You can also see it in how people relate to each other, so behavioral aspects. So besides the technical operational side of things, we see exactly the same in how people interact with each other. The moment they see value and there is a way that we can actually be stronger together, there is suddenly a move forward into the right direction. So there's a very much, very high, I would say, forward-looking and value-added thinking if you're willing to actually bridge to somebody else and see that the both of you are stronger.
Did you bring in additional, say, help forces, so to say, to help you manage those behavioral stuff?
Yeah, we are in a pretty big project. So it means that it provides an interest and a benefit to the project to actually get people which are skilled in how to actually deal with the dynamics in teams. So what we did is we hired a consulting company which actually brought all kinds of techniques and interests on how you could actually create an environment which is stronger to perform from a technical side. It really helps. It is really one of those methodologies which could be added to the skill set of a project manager, that you're not doing it by yourself and not by yourself alone. There are people out there who have a better view on how to actually deal with this kind of complexity.
What was the initial response of people or reaction of people when you first brought in these behavioral stuff?
It is a difficult thing for most people because it means that you have to be open-minded for new ways of doing things. Imagine the world that all the engineers are very badass skilled, so very good in data and number crunching and understanding how analysis work and how to deal with information. They're in a processing mind. The moment you start to almost confront those people with the lack of training from a social intellectual skill set, it needs an open mind to actually understand that this is a piece of tool in their toolbox. They look at it as a potential threat or danger that they are basically pinpointed down to some sort of flaw in the way they operate, which is not. It's just a lacking of knowledge in that field.
Do you have recommendations for your fellow project managers to better manage project complexity in the future?
Yeah, if I would say something, it would be relationship. Focus on the relationship. So the entire project is one big web of relationship with people. It's subcontractors and main contractor, it's main contractor and owner. It's everywhere where you look, our relationship amongst teams of one group of people. So even within the owner, we see people working with each other. So if you would focus on the relationship and understand what it means to be in a trust and respectful environment, then suddenly the world of opportunity is in front of us. And that's one of the things I hope that in the future project managers should have a much keener eye on. It's not only a technical solution what we are providing, it's an end game of building the plan together.
Should we do something in our curriculum to that end?
If I would say yes, I'm technically trained, I'm an engineer by background. I wish I was much stronger in psychology and sociology.
Thanks for your time.
Thank you.